Morning friends, Andy Moon here. Today I am here to discuss about the topic privatization will lead to the less corruption. In my view, corruption depends on the one's selfishness. Not only in private sector or public sector, both are corrupted. The man's attitude should change. If he was not ready to take bribe, then there will be no corruption, no? And in privatization, there are many risks of corruption. So we fear about the authority to take bribes. But in the government sector, there are no strict rules, so they are taking bribes unnecessarily, and it leaves the effect on the GDP of our country and development of our country also. So I say privatization will lead to less corruption.
Yes, I agree with you. According to my opinion, job security of government sectors is leads to bribes increasing. In that, well, privatization involves that to make that corruption is reduced. I give the one example for that. In 2005, I found that more than 62% of Indians get jobs during this corruption by means of the bribes. In 2013, the rank of India in corruption is 84. Meanwhile, in 2014, rank of India is 84. So, compared to neighboring other countries, the rank of the China is 100 and rank of the Pakistan is 126.
Yes, I agree with you. As I do believe that in private organizations, there is less corruption than government, because in private organizations, their employees are being paid with higher salaries and they are hesitant to take bribes from other persons. And in private organizations, the employees are always in between the high observation with their HRs and other higher staff. So in private organizations, there is less corruption. Not only that, in a private organization, the economical growth also improves our country. Because let me give an example. In our state, our CM Chandrababu Naidu have greatly developed the Hyderabad city with giving a good private opportunities to build their centers in our Hyderabad. Yes,
my friend. My point of view agree with you, and I want to say that privatization leads to less corruption because of privatization. They always encourage the employees, they offering some more benefits, and they offering packages in weekly, monthly and yearly, and they check update, they check time to time, and they giving more strict rules on the time of this type of doings, like getting corrupt, getting bribe, and calling for and trying to take for a bribe. All the situations they are punished severely because they will be checked time to time, and in the same way they take some short time to complete one task. In this case, they don't have time to take bribes and all these, and they don't think about other things like taking bribes, all this. So my point of view, privatization leads to less corruption as compared to government sectors.
I agree with you, Balaji. Not only in private sectors, not only in government sectors, private sectors also corrupted. For example, in Satyam scam, so much money was corrupted by management.
I agree with you, my friend. When we take private organization, the government projects are taken up by private organization, They have to show every amount of money to the government, how they contributed to their project. But government organizations, government projects cannot show to the government. Of course, private organization will lead to less corruption.
But when we see that in some Mumbai, this is elections are involved, where it taking place very good. But when we see that in textiles, the cotton which was approved and approved in the industries, private industries, will be giving some more qualities and by keeping some acoustics in that, by improving that, there was more damage to that and they were not present at more for more times and more years. So that by moving that, they are bringing so much money and they are getting more amount of money, more than that of government which was paid.
So say, not only in government sectors, in the private sector also corrupted men. Let me take an example of Commonwealth Games. The money allotted for the Commonwealth Games was 9,000 crores. But the management of Commonwealth Games has only just half of the money was spent on the Indian players and the rest of the money was corrupted by them. So I say not only private sector, government sector also has more corruption. If you take the other courts and every municipal corporations, everywhere there is we have to give bribes to the officers.
As I see that in government sectors like RTO offices, when I went there, the time taken by the work completed, they have taken more bribes and they are taking more amount for to complete that work.
I agree with you. Yeah. Corruption is due to man's selfishness, as you said, the modern friend. Due to this corruption, India will face so many problems. Due to this corruption, India will become a developing country. Once we can avoid the corruption, India will become the very development country, I'm sure this is that. Yeah. I give the one example for that. In US, my friend also wanted to say that Commonwealth scams in nearly 70,000 crores. In also, yeah, and another example for that, and coal mining also, there is 1.86 lakhs are nearly lost by the corruption. Yeah.
Yes. You know, people generally think that is government sector is always corruption and private. Then we see that all the mines and quarries are always undertaken by private organizations and they are all corrupted because of the corruption. The corruption depends on the individual who take the responsibilities and they always think that they are selfish and so corrupted.
Corruption means misuse the public power for personal gains. Corruption has been the part of the human society since that the oldest time. Corruption, theft and fraud is the these are all increase the money for the cost of others. Corruption is
which
man who can live with honesty is the person.
Yes. I agree with you. I also give the one example for that. Yeah. While you're getting the any license and any other parts, whatever there, when we are going to government offices and purchase the amount to that, in this way the corruption is involved takes place. It is in government sector. Coming to the private sector, there are so many fields and technology is developed. While we are getting the license and while we are getting the other parts in internet also. In this way, corruption is reduced, the privatization is reduced the corruption.
I do agree with you, but when we see the companies like Reliance or some other, they are giving free amount or something. The scheme of value is very, but in the scheme of another value, that getting more amount of money rather than we pay.
Yes, I suggested that both government and private sectors have been corrupted. Like my mission example of privatization sector, we know that Fuji scam, it was about 1,50,000 crore reports were scam. It is shaken all over the country. Of course, both are corrupted. It mainly based upon individual.
Okay, so my friends, my point of view, reduce the corruption. Please check time to time the bills and salary applications and salary bills time to time, and don't involve them for taking bribe. And everybody should be strictly punished when he or she taking bribe. If he is private organization or government organization, the same way everyone should responsibility to inform if there is any bribe case you are seen by you, urgently can inform to the nearby society people, nearby the government sectors. So corruption means really Mohan said that it's only depends upon one's mindset. It's only decreased by changing our mindset that to develop our country, that's our responsibility, then only we have to decrease the corruption throughout the India and throughout in organization like private organization and government organization.
Friends, I say that as it was privatization or government sectors, anyway, if the person's attitude changes, then everything will be good. If the person don't want to take bribes, then how the corruption will be done? So, to decrease the corruption, there are two ways. One side is from the government and one side from the people. If the government has strict rules given by the government, then we get fear to take the bribes. And if the people changes, if they are aware about the corruption and how the national GDP was affected by the corruption, then they can be aware and fight against the corruption. So the problem will be solved.
I finally conclude that corruption is not caused by means of government sectors and private sectors. It is depends upon the man's attitude and ability. Thank you.
Thank you, Varuna. Your GD on privatization will lead to less corruption. It went on well and everybody participated well. I appreciate all the candidates and team. But I have few things to speak to you people. Coming to candidate 1, you took good lead initiation as well as you have come up with the solution for the problem. But actually, throughout the discussion, you weren't very active. I want people like you to be very active throughout the discussion, try to involve in the group and take up opportunity to guide the team members whenever possible. And coming to candidate 2, you expressed your ideas very clearly, giving some very good examples. But what I felt is you're supposed to avoid that hesitation. You are not very confident expressing your ideas. You have many to express, but thing is, you are not very confident, you are a little hesitant, try to avoid that. And coming to candidate 3, please don't try to maintain eye contact with your facilitator over here. Try to maintain eye contact with team members within the team. And apart from that, your ideas were very clear. You have come up with a good number of ideas related to the topic, but your voice modulation needs improvement. You are supposed to improve with your voice modulation. And coming to candidate 4, you are not supposed to hesitate to speak when you are in a group. When you are among a group, you are not supposed to hesitate. And at the same time, you are silent throughout the discussion. You did not speak much. You did not try to at least take up or grab the opportunity while speaking. So I wanted you to improve on that area. Try to try practicing speaking. Thank you. And coming to candidate 5, you're very confident. Your confidence is revealed. But at the same time, your body posture as well as your personal grooming needs little improvement. 6. You are supposed to avoid gap fillers, and at the same time, you are very panicked when you are speaking. You are supposed to avoid it. Don't be panicked. And at the same time, try to be very confident. Your ideas are very, very good. You have been one of the core members in the discussion. And I would like to appreciate candidate 1, 3, 5 and 6. You have been the core of the discussion and it all went on well. And at the same time, coming to candidate 7, you are also just like candidate 4. You are very silent throughout the discussion. You did not participate much. And if you are like that, if you are a silent member, maybe you will not be selected, you will be eliminated from the group discussion. Try to speak something in the discussion. And coming to candidate 8, you involved in the discussion. Maybe I think you are not aware of the topic, maybe you are not very good with your content. So you can develop on your ideas on others' points. If you really are not having anything to speak, try to take up the opportunity to develop on other points. Okay? And the discussion went on well. Thank you one and all.